All right, so I was having trouble fitting this little die in here. Notice that some of these others are a little bit larger and they fit in really snug. These little ones, we can make them work. And here's a way that I can make it work. I've got a little bit of wet clay, just a little bit I grabbed a moment ago. Actually, I'm gonna grab some wetter clay and stick it inside of there. I'm just squishing that wet clay inside of here, because I'm gonna stick the dog to that wet clay. Sorry, you can't see what I'm doing while I'm up this way, but I've stuck it in there, and now when I go to screw this on, I'm gonna use the pressure of the clay that I drop in here to make it work. So I've got a little tube that's about the same diameter as the extruder tube that I'm gonna put in there. I like to have that prepared ahead of time so that it'll fit easily. And then I stick this whole thing in here. I've got a screw on the back. And then I can use the hand pump to start pumping this out. If you've used a caulking gun, this is what you're doing. And I don't have a ton of clay in here, so eventually I'll get some pressure. There we go. And now my dog or my star or my tube or whatever it is I'm pushing out of here will start to come out. So you see that this is squeezing out. I'm going to use just a knife to cut it off because this is sort of a funny little shape here. You can see the dog on the end. And this kind of extrusion is sometimes used to make little dog shapes. Or we've got some other animals as well. It's kind of a funny extrusion, but you can see, you can get a bunch of little hopefully you can see, you can get a bunch of little matching critters or whatever it is you want to use. You could potentially also find, you know, other things that you could sculpt with this funny shape. Now, one thing you notice here is I'm getting some ripping happening on the sides here. Two reasons the ripping happens. Well, three. One is that the die is pretty small. But to help with this, one of the things I can do is have that clay that I put in originally be a little bit closer to the diameter, be kind of fussy about getting it the same diameter as the tube. Another thing that I can do is I can try to use a little bit wetter clay. So I wedged this up and then it was sitting for a while. If the clay is a bit wetter, it may not do that. Porcelain may also do a little bit less of that. Now we've got all these other dies that work much the same way, and you're not going to have that kind of ripping problem with circles and squares, right? You also know, or you will know, depending when you're watching this video, how to do some cleanup, some patching on some of these edges. So that is how you use this extruder gun. When you are done with it, you're going to want to unscrew it. You can let up your pressure back here. I always forget this part. You can let up your pressure back here by pushing, I think. There we go. And then this thing can kind of come back. This will unscrew. The front will unscrew as well. And of course, just like the other extruder, to get that extra clay out of here, you can push it through. But I don't use this one as much. I probably should have left that attached to there, shouldn't I? You can do it either way. You can take it all apart to begin with. Otherwise, you need to, if you want some pressure help to get it on there. Just a leverage issue here. All right, so the metal thing that I'm pushing is helping me get this part back farther, and I'm just having trouble getting it far enough to screw back on here. Alright, let's say you don't do that way. You can also go through and get this out with a fiddling knife. You can just take and cut it out of there. This as well, just like the other, just like the large extruder, you can obviously take this over to the sink to do some cleaning of it. Without the video on, I'm going to put this back on and I'm going to squeeze that out to get it cleaned out.